quantitative interpretation of magnetic or magnitude of metal complex. Quantitative interpretation of magnetic momentum of metal complex. So it never allow to explain what is the quantity of magnetic momentum or magnitude, magnetic data available with coordination complex. Whereas, what is the next one? It does not explain color property of coordination complexes. Color property. Only some amount of magnetic properties are satisfiedly explained by valency bond theory, but not quantitative interpretation of that magnetic data. And also, it fails to explain color properties of coordination complexes because many of the coordination complexes exhibit color. And next one, it also failed to explain quantitative interpretation of thermodynamic and kinetic stabilities of metal complexes. Kinetic and thermodynamic stabilities of metal complexes does not explain by VBT. And also does not explain weak and strong ligands. It does not explain weak and strong ligands. So these are some limitations or drawbacks we can identify, and also the manner of hybridization. The pattern of hybridization is also failed to explain under VBT, valency bond theory. So to overcome some drawbacks with this, let us explain the next theory, which explains us about the formation of coordination complexes or crystal field theory. What is the next one? Crystal field theory. So as per the consequence, we can write it as CFT, crystal field theory. So once again, we are going to explain the formation of 4 coordinate and 6 coordinate metal complexes with the help of crystal field theory. Here, the crystal field theory depends upon the splitting of d orbitals present at central metal ion or metal atom in the presence of ligands. Here, to explain the formation of metal complexes, as per this theory, the strong field ligands and weak field ligands in octahedral geometry and tetrahedral geometry are our consideration. So let us write. So once again, as per the crystal field theory, in the presence of ligands that may be neutral ligands or negatively charged ligands while approaching towards the central metal atom or metal ion, the orbitals, the degeneracy state of orbitals present in central metal atom undergoes splitting. That means 5 d orbitals are arranged in 2 different energy levels. So let us have splitting of d orbitals in octahedral complexes. Octahedral complexes. So we have to remember that actually this is an octahedral complex L and L. Here this is the manner of coordination expected to present with octahedral geometry. So we can represent it as x-axis, or we can consider it as y-axis, x-axis, and the dihedral line which is called as z-axis. So remember, onto the central metal atom or metal ion, six ligands are approaching in the desired manner to occupy octa, or to facilitate or to provide octahedral geometry for this metal complexes. In such manner, out of five orbitals, 5d orbitals. So what are the names for those? Dxy, dyz, dzx, dx square, y square, and dz square. So these are the 5d orbitals present inside of the metal atom. So out of 5d orbitals, those d orbitals which faces more repulsion with the electrons of ligand, that means out of the 5, some of the orbitals are arranged within the axis or in between the axis, whereas some of the d orbital arranged onto the axis. So those d orbitals which are present within the axis, xyz axis, face the orbitals present in between the axis face less repulsions, and the orbitals present onto the axis face more repulsion. So this will be happened, means the ligands are electron pair donors. While they are approaching here, electrons of ligand and orbitals d orbitals, some repulsions are takes place between electrons of ligand and d orbitals. So in such case, those d orbitals which are present in between the axis face less repulsion with ligands, whereas the orbitals which are present onto the axis will face more repulsions with ligands, due to which the 5 orbitals, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these 5 orbitals in the presence of, it is d orbitals present in metal atom,